There's no way home, and I have no mercy. There's no way up, so I'm going down. Still I keep on living, so you pull me closer. When I have no mercy, let's carry on. No reasons to stop it. I wouldn't do it on my own, I can't deny it. Still trying to build and trying to be. When we
why don't you say so?
They watch my moves, yeah. Do my dance, I'm skinny little bitch, still shaking ass.
And they shit free, nigga, show me cash. Fuck a broke boy, I been had a bag. I come in first place, I never been last. A bitch act stupid, bitch get trash.
Stereotypes given to the signs that aren't actually true.
Cancer and Pisces are not the most sensitive sign. Leo is. Leo's ruled by their ego, which is the most sensitive thing about any single human being. Tauruses aren't actually stubborn. They just really know what they want and how they want it. Cancers don't actually have a shell. They're just not in the mood to talk to you. Not all Capricorns are successful. They just know how to manage their money very, very well. Not all Aquariuses are detached and unemotional. They just genuinely don't know what they're doing when it comes to sharing their emotions. Libras aren't indecisive. They're just... Wait, they're so indecisive. What am I saying? Of course I was manipulating you.
That hurts my feelings. I've been good to you, Dean.
I'm a cop, remember?
But the king's dead.
Long live the queen. You need to mind your own beeswax.
Kinda always wanted to punch the devil in the face.
Shall we play a game, bitches?
Cause you know that, baby.
How to piss off each zodiac sign, because nobody asked. First, Aries. Keep asking them if they're mad even when they're acting totally normal. Now, Taurus. Wake them up from sleeping. That's it, just wake them up from sleeping. They would hate that. Gemini. Tell them that you have tea to spill, but delay it as long as possible. Like, oh, sorry, I'll tell you later. Oh, I'll tell you later. Cancer. Ask them to make you a playlist, then don't listen to it. Leo. Tell them that they look really good and you want to take a photo of them, but then take it so that they're barely in the frame. It's just wrong. And Virgo, ask them to meet you somewhere and say that they really have to be on time, then show up 10 minutes late. So evil. Okay, like for part two.
Part two of roasting the zodiac signs because I'm bored and because I can. And if you can't take a joke, that's on you, not on me. But if you can, fuck it. Virgos, next time you try to give someone your unwarranted and unwanted advice, make sure that you take it first, you hypocrite. Virgos, keep telling yourself that the world revolves around you because the rest of us just think you're delusional and are ready to check you into an institution. Cancers, you have all of the worst qualities of every other zodiac all bundled up into one. You're manipulative, you're moody, you're inconsistent, and you refuse to see when you're wrong. Pick a struggle. Geminis, next time you try to repeat that joke because you thought nobody heard it, don't. We heard it, it just wasn't funny. Tauruses, you know what? I actually don't think you're as boring as I say you are. I do, however, think you are the whiniest zodiac who finds a reason to complain about everything. Aries, grow up and get a therapist. Seriously, you need it. Posting the zodiac signs because I'm bored and I can, and if you can't take a joke, that's on you. But if you can, follow me, bitch. Probably gonna be two parts of this. Pisces, stop complaining about other people when we all know that you're your own biggest problem. Aquarius, there's a reason there's so little astrology content about you. It's because you're just not as interesting as you might think. Capricorn, next time your overcritical, judgmental ass tries to comfort someone, just remember, bringing other people down won't mask the fact that you're an insecure narcissist. Sagittarius, the only reason people like you is because you copycat what cooler people do, but you just do it louder. You're not actually funny, you're just a mimic. Scorpios, y'all like to say that you know you're crazy and you're like, yeah, I'm a bad bitch. But if you actually knew you were crazy, wouldn't you be doing something about it? Libras, I honestly for a second forgot who I was roasting. Not because you changed your personality again, but because you're so irrelevant, I forgot you existed.
The most to least dangerous signs. Coming in at 12th place at the least dangerous? Gemini. I know, I'm shocked too. If they don't have too much power, they wouldn't really hurt a fly. 11th place, Aquarius. You guys are too mellow and don't want drama like that anyway. 10th place, Leo. They play the tough role, but they won't do nothing. 9th place, Scorpio. Just don't push them. 8th place, Pisces. They have hidden rage, but most of the time, it's not that serious. 7th place, Libra. They don't want to hurt you, honestly. But they will. Most dangerous signs. Coming in at 6th place, Virgo. When Virgo decides to get up in your face, back up. 5th place, Capricorn. When Capricorn doesn't decide to hold back what they want to say, that's your cue to leave. Coming in at 4th place, Aries. No surprise here. They will put you in your place. 3rd place, Sagittarius. You get a warning first. Take it. 2nd place, Taurus. Especially if you hurt somebody they loved. 1st place is Cancer.
What's wrong with you girls? You're supposed to start crying when we hit you.
Yeah! What are you guys, new?
Yeah! We're the Powerpuff Girls!
And it takes a lot more than a couple of cheap shots to make us cry.
Who is the biggest crybaby of the zodiac signs? Obviously Cancer.
Cancer.
Why is everyone ganging up on me? Aries. Capricorn, why do you hate me? See how sensitive he is. Pisces, I know you're not talking. Why can't we just relax? WTF. Let's be honest, all the water signs are crybabies. I know you did not. Scorpio, you're still not over the time Sag said she didn't like your haircut. It's Aries, Pisces, and Cancer. It's not my fault you guys are always mean. Here comes the sob story. They proved our point.
Oh my god, he's dead? No!
Expectations versus reality. Everyone always expects Aries to always want to fight you or get loud and punch the wall. But in reality, their personality lights up the room. Everyone expects Taurus to always be eating food and staying at home and very emotionless. But in reality, they're really good friends and are trustworthy. And they could be sweethearts. Security and comfort is important to them. Everyone expects Geminis to be two-faced, laughs at their own jokes, and not knowing when to stop talking. When in reality, they're the most entertaining people out there. They can actually hold a conversation and make you laugh. Everyone expects Cancers to be crybabies, innocent, and an emotional wreck. In reality, they actually think about intimacy way more than you think. And they can't help that their emotions have a tendency to get spilled out.
Five facts about your zodiac sign. If you're new in this series, we learn fun things about ourselves. Sagittarians are celebrities. A study found that those born between these dates are more likely to become famous. Leos are the worst drivers. Data shows that those born between this time are more likely to get a speeding ticket. Libras become rich. This sign has the most billionaires. Aquarians turn pro. More professional athletes are born between this range. Scorpios are presidential. Aside from Aquarians, no other sign has more presidents than this range.
My toxic trait is making you think I'm a dumbass. So when you think you got me fooled, I'm actually three steps ahead.
Corrupted and such is far away. Your love's like rhinestone.
She's a good girl. And it felt great to be a liar. She's a good girl. And it felt great to be a liar.
As much as I can.
What is this pulling out? It just feels good.
Yep, and it brings down the skin's temperature. See how it kind of got stuck on the beard?
the three signs most likely to survive the apocalypse. 1. Taurus. They would be sleeping and prepared in their underground bunker with beans and rice for years. Absolutely indestructible beings. The second would be Virgo, another earth sign. Most definitely very well prepared with a survival plan. Probably has astronaut food ready to go, along with a connection to someone working at SpaceX so they can literally flee the planet. And the third sign to survive the apocalypse will be Pisces. Pisces would somehow astral project to 7D collective consciousness and completely bypass the experience. They would just be like, no, and just leave Earth. Click plus for more.
How all the zodiac signs apologize. I guess. I'm sorry. I guess. Oops. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. You're such a sensitive ass bitch. Sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. What the fuck? I don't have anything to apologize for. I'm so sorry. And I really hope you can believe me, because I mean it. Okay, I'm sorry. I really am sorry. But I want you to know that I was still right, so. I'm sorry. I'm still the shit, so. Oh, shit. Did I do that? Oh, my bad. My bad, yo. Sorry. I'm sorry. Are we done? Oh, my God. I'm so sorry. I am literally the dirt under your shoes. I'm so sorry. Seriously.
Baby, I'm not even here. I'm a hallucination.
This is where you should be seated in a car based on your zodiac sign. In the driver's seat, we should have a Virgo because they're most likely not to crash the car. Next to the Virgo, we should have a Leo or a Libra because they have the most palatable music taste and will probably play something that everybody in the car likes. Right here, this is the person who has the most access to everybody, so that should be a Gemini because they're probably going to do the most engaging and talk a lot. Next to the Gemini, we should have a Capricorn or an Aries to tell them to shut the fuck up. Behind the Aries, we should have a Cancer so the Cancer can be chill if they need to because they're in the back, or they can talk if they want. And in this seat, we should have a Sagittarius because they're loud as fuck and we don't want the driver to get distracted, but they can also keep the Cancer engaged. And in front of and outside of the car, we can have a Taurus to run over.
Cause you know that, baby, I'm your biggest fan.
Shout out to everyone who's a Virgo, Cancer, Leo, Aries, Aquarius, Scorpio, and Sagittarius. You're all emotional little shits who try your best to stay strong while you're truly hurting inside and walk around with the I'm fine attitude, but you're really not fine.
Shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any.
Part 2 of how to piss off each zodiac sign again because nobody asked. Libra, tell them that you want to make plans with them and then give them 10 options to choose from. Scorpio, just block them on all social media so that they can't stalk you. Sagittarius, ask them to tell you a funny story and then in the middle of their story, start telling them a story. Capricorn, this one's a classic. Just ask them for life advice and then don't take it. Aquarius, make them a presentation on something that they're really passionate about, like global warming, and then get all of the facts wrong. And Pisces, start a movie so that they get very emotionally attached to each character, and then at the best part, turn it off. Don't try this at home, kids.
If there was a group chat with just fire and air signs. OMG, my ex just texted me. Which one though? Yeah. Honestly. The one y'all hate. So all of them. Ah, the Pisces. Sends voice note. Let's just FaceTime. Okay, I look good. No one cares. Fuck you. I mean, we did last week. T. But I already knew that. So should I text them back? Y'all WTF, I'm the ex.
Observe. I am a Rorfian Zopgar. On my planet, this is hilarious.
Bestie, answer your phone, bestie.
I did the thing that you told me not to do, and I hurt myself in the process.
You got me hype, I wanna bite it right now, yeah, yeah. Say, ah, yeah, 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 yeah.
Stereotypes given to the signs that aren't actually true.
Pisces aren't actually dreamers or in their own world. They're just always high. Sagittariuses aren't actually afraid of commitment. They just want to be able to experience everything and anything without somebody holding them back. Virgos aren't actually perfectionists. They just strive for the best, which makes it seem like they're perfect. Geminis aren't actually two-faced. They just know how to adapt to their surroundings and different personalities and get along with everybody. Aries don't actually have a short fuse. It's just their fire going off when something doesn't go their way, but they get over it in literally 2 seconds. Scorpios aren't actually unforgivable. Like, they'll forgive you, but you best believe they won't ever forget what you did, and they'll hold it against you.
Feel like being a bitch today.
I guess you didn't mean what you wrote in that song about me. You said forever, now I drive alone past your street.
Red lights, stop sign.
Right now I have 7 boyfriends. I don't know which one is my favorite. I don't know their names, but I have 7 boyfriends, and yeah, we just get each other. 2 of those boys are brothers.